disaster just struck. It can be any disaster, natural or human-made. There are lots of information flowing around, and there are generally two types, right information or wrong information. This type is more fun to share and travels really fast, I tell you. But the question is, how people decide whether it is right or wrong information, and when the decision is made, how people decide to whom the information is relevant. That is my research is all about. No, that's not me. This is me. I investigated the thought process of information sharing during disaster. I use qualitative critical incident technique interview methods. Then I use the inter-rater reliability test to ensure the reliability of my findings.
What is that?
Just like having a group of auditors to audit the quality of my findings. I found that there are two phases of the thought process. Phase one is when people receive the information. The process starts when the information is received from a source through a medium. Then people filter the information using cognitive resources.
What is that?
Memory or experience. And then they use different decision-making techniques to decide whether the information is right or wrong. Then phase two process starts. In this phase, people match the information they receive with a different set of existing memory or experience, and then using different decision-making tactics to decide to whom the information is relevant. So for the big question, so what? And who cares? For those in the academic circle, my research adds theoretical knowledge to areas in disaster management, knowledge management, and naturalistic decision making. For those in the practitioner circles, who usually think that theories are so boring, my research can also help. This includes to improve information sharing policy, to improve training modules, and to help developing disaster management or information sharing systems. My future research plans, if there are findings, includes to test the two-phase thought process of receiving and sharing information in various cultural group settings or in specific recent disaster such as pandemic or act of terrorism, and to study how people handle information when they have no disaster experience before.